Hi everyone, it's Vicky here, and today I'm going to create three cards using a new stamp set that has been just released by Simon Says Stamp. This is a rubber stamp and it's called Christmas Sweater. It's a big stamp, so it would cover up a standard card vertically or horizontally. So I'm going to show you three different ideas on how you can use this stamp for making Christmas cards. First, I'm going to start with this red panel and I am preparing my surface with powder so that I can do some embossing later on. Now this tool allows my embossing powder to stick where only where it's supposed to, since it removes static electricity. So I'm going to go ahead and apply my Versamark ink on top of my rubber stamp, and I always like to keep the big stamp on top of my table and apply the paper on top, since I always find that I get a better impression this way. Of course, you can use your stamping platform if you wish so, but I want to show you that you can do it even if you don't have a stamping platform and you still get great results. So now I am going to apply my white embossing powder. This is fine embossing powder, so I will be able to get every little detail of this stamp. I am using my heat gun to melt the embossing powder. Now my background is quite busy, so one way to add a sentiment is to cut out a window. So as you can see, I am going to stamp a sentiment on the card base directly, and you will be able to see the sentiment through the window. Now I'm working on a standard card that's 4.25 by 5.5, and I'm going to stamp the sentiment with Versamark ink and then white emboss it, so it's going to match perfectly my background. I'm using my Misti to make sure that I stamp everything correctly. And by the way, you can use any sentiment that you have that matches a Christmas card. I decided to go with one that says "May your Christmas be merry and bright," and this comes from a stamp set that has been released by Simon Says Stamp from a previous release. I think it was from last year, and you will find links to that down below. Now I am going to embellish my card just a little bit more. For the final touch, I decided to go with this satin ribbon, which I am going to wrap on one side, just like you see here. I am going to use some tape runner at the back, just to make sure that this is going to stay put. And now I'm going to wrap my ribbon on the other side and tie a bow. I'm going to use my scissors to cut out the tails of my bow, and then all that's left to do is to stick this panel on top of my card base. I'm going to add some foam tip at the back, and as I stick this panel on top, I will make sure that I align the sentiment so it's nice and centered and you can read the sentiment through that window. For the second card, I'm going to do some stamping, and this time I decided to use my Misti to do so. So I am going to stamp on a piece of white cardstock, and I'm using Schoolhouse Red. This is an ink by Simon Says Stamp. And for my card design, I don't want to use the whole piece, so I'm going to use my paper trimmer and cut out half of this design. And then I will go ahead and stick that at the very bottom of my card base. For my sentiment, I am just going to go simple, so I will use a die cut. Of course, you can use any die cut that you have that matches Christmas cards, or you can even stamp your sentiment on top. Now, I will go ahead and use some tape at the back of my pattern paper there. I'm going to stick it at the very bottom of my card base. And now from the cutout, I am only going to use the word Merry. And I'm going to combine this cutout with a sentiment that says Christmas. So I went through my stash to try and find the word Christmas in a stamp that is quite small and would fit just underneath the cutout. And I found this Simon Says stamp from that last year that's called Merry and Bright, and you will find links to that down below. They are both the stamp and the die that I used is still available online. So again, I used my Versamark ink to stamp the word Christmas. I am applying my white embossing powder, and then I will go ahead and heat set it. This is a very quick and simple design that you can easily mass produce, especially if you use only die cuts for your sentiment. Now I'm going to stick that on top of my little Christmas word there, and my card is finished. Now for the third card, again I'm going to use my Misty and do some stamping. I'm using my Versamark ink again, and I'm going to stamp on top of a craft cardstock. I'm going to apply some white embossing powder this time, and I really like this combination of white embossed image on top of the craft cardstock. I'm going to use my heat gun to melt everything. And again, this is going to be a quick and simple card, so all I'm going to do is to stick a sentiment. For that I did go again with the same sentiment as the previous card that says Merry and Bright, and I did cut it out of gold cardstock as well as of white, and I'm going to stick one on top of the other. This way I'm going to end up with quite of a thicker sentiment that gives a bit of dimension on top of my card. I did use my Nouveau Deluxe white glue at the back, and I'm going to stick all those words on top of my panel. And again, I'm going to use the same cardstock as I used for the die cut, and I'm going to cut out a panel. This panel is going to cover up completely my card base, and I'm going to stick that on top. Now before I stick it, I'm going to add some texture and embellish my panel a little bit more. So I'm going with this golden thread. Actually, this is a thread that I got from a craft fair a few years ago. I'm going to wrap this thread three times around my panel, and I have tape adhesive at the back, so this is going to secure the thread. And now I have two little golden jingle bells which I'm going to thread through that string, and then I'm going to tie them on top of my panel. This way I will end up having a nice little bow and those jingle bells making the noise. Of course, this is quite bulky as a card, so I wouldn't send this with through the mail, but I plan to add this card inside a Christmas gift and hand it out to the recipient. And finally, I'm going to stick this panel by using foam tape at the back on top of my card base, and my card is finished. So let's take a quick look on all the three cards that I made for today. This is a really beautiful background stamp, and I hope I inspire you to create some quick and easy designs, but at the same time really beautiful. Here are some close-up photos of the cards that I made today. I hope you had fun and got inspired, and if you did, don't forget to leave me a comment as well as give me a thumbs up on my YouTube channel. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel already, make sure to do so, because this is the way to tell me that you like my videos and you want to see more. Thank you all for watching, and see you next time.